Let's go towards midday in Europe, and we have the honor to have with us the former Minister of Tourism of Greece, Elena Kontoura. You are as well member of the European Parliament, and you are very committed, very focused as well on tourism and always on tourism. Thank you, Elena, to be with us. What are your considerations about the relaunching of tourism after this crisis?
First of all, thank you so much for the invitation, and I would like to congratulate the organizers as well as the distinguished speakers for their leadership and for their efforts to support the travel, tourism, and hospitality, especially throughout this unprecedented crisis. The ongoing pandemic calls for more cooperation, more coordinated responses, and more practical solutions until this crisis is over and beyond. During my term as Minister of Tourism of Greece, from 2015 to 2019, I dealt with several crises, including consecutive elections, the financial crisis, the imposition of capital controls, refugee issues, very saddening events regarding safety and security in the wider area, as well as natural disasters. Already from 2015, I had launched our new national tourism strategy for establishing Greece as a 365-day destination, and along with a very targeted plan, we managed not only to surpass each crisis and safeguard tourism, but we achieved record-breaking numbers, arrivals, and revenues every year. Tourism for Greece became a catalyst for the economy recovery, and we accomplished to make Greece a champion, if you permit it to say, in Europe, and a leading example globally. The performance of tourism was great in all the measures, arrivals, and revenues. We did so by strategically extending the summer season, increasing tourism in the winter season. We opened new dynamic source markets abroad and introduced new Greek destinations. We developed new thematic products based on unique, authentic experiences and sustainable growth. And by doing so, we attract a phenomenal number of new investments. But building resilience in tourism is non-stop effort. It depends on the comparative advantages of each area, whether Europe, the Mediterranean, or Asia, for example, and also on the extraordinary challenges and events that might occur. Crisis for, I would say, of such scale require broader transnational, peripheral, and global cooperation because no one can do it alone, not even the most powerful. The pandemic is still here, and in some areas, such as in Europe, we are already experiencing the second wave. Although we have encouraging news for the vaccine, we still have a long way to go. And until then, we have to learn to function every day in this new reality. The public authorities, but also businesses, working force, and consumers need to adjust. We cannot postpone to invest in prevention and safety. It's better to prevent and prepare than have to go through another quarantine. From my current position as a member of European Parliament and also coordinator of my group, my political group in the Transport and Tourism Committee, I have made several interventions to the European institutions for a concrete plan to protect and support tourism and travel as a top priority for the whole European Union. Don't forget that Europe is the first destination, and it's the 10% of the GDP tourism and more than 22 million jobs. So many of my proposals have been widely accepted and are included in the last two resolutions for tourism of the European Parliament in October 2019 and in June 2020. I have asked from the European Commission to establish common safety protocols for travel and tourism, accommodation, and for all modes of transportation. All travelers should be able to know at any given moment which rules apply. We must absolutely have mandatory tests, fast, reliable, and free of charge for citizens. And we should follow strictly the same set of recommendations for use of masks, hygiene measures, distances, so that we can contain the spread as much as possible. Dealing with the health crisis is not enough. It is equally important to deal with the impact of the economies and the society and in sectors that were hit very hard. So it's a top priority to protect businesses and employment in tourism with state aid and adequate funding in all sectors and jobs related to tourism, hospitality, and accommodation. We cannot allow millions of jobs to be lost or the most vulnerable business to bankrupt, to shut down, or to be bought and unfair competition to prevail. Another proposal I submitted and was also adopted by the European Parliament is the creation of the first time of a European mechanism for crisis management in tourism, which will handle all future crises, whether it is about health, climate change, natural disasters, or safety. We have serious challenges ahead. Having in mind that tourism is a powerful accelerator for growth and global and the global agenda for sustainable development, as well as the European Green Deal, require big steps for its green and digital transition. As a service-based activity that depends on real interaction between people, it will always maintain the majority of jobs and relatively more than other sectors in the process of digitalization. But we need a strong transformation for tourism to remain competitive and safe. And now, with all the new technological advances with innovation and artificial intelligence, we can make tourism and travel more safe and more seamless. The freedom of movement is really something wonderful that we have accomplished, and we cannot afford to lose it. Finally, we should focus on how to make the travel experience not only safer, but even greater. The global trend for alternative tourism and thematic experience of high added value has gained momentum. Both the public and the private sector should encourage and invest more in developing sustainable forms of tourism, such as ecotourism, agritourism, bicycle tourism, wellness tourism, and so much more. As we often say, tourism is all about the people, about their well-being and prosperity. From my current position as member of the European Parliament, I will continue to support ideas, cooperations, and action that maximize the benefits of tourism to the people.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Elena. Yes, focus to the people.